Hello, my little crafty monsters. How's everybody doing today? I hope everybody is fabulous. So, in today's fabulous tutorial, we are going to be making these adorable little... Well, they're not adorable. They're more of a, like, they're pretty. They're just really dainty, really soft. We have some vellum leaves going on. We have some little inking that we did in the background. And then this is some little embossed silver. Put some little gems on there. On the inside, let's read what the inside says. Whoa, oh, calm down. I have to open up too so that we can both read. It says, thinking of you, especially today, and wishing you a happy Mother's Day. So this is a perfect little Mother's Day for maybe your mom, if your mom is an angel like mine is. Then maybe you could give one to your sister, because, you know, maybe your sister is a mother, or a friend, or, I mean, your grandparent, I mean, your grandma. I don't know why I said grandpa. You would not be giving your grandpa a Mother's Day card. Unless it was that kind of a relationship. But anyway, this is an amazing little Mother's Day card. It is super, super easy and super, super beautiful looking. And I'm going to go ahead and show you guys how to make that right now. So let's not waste any more time, because I know you guys want to get down and dirty, boo-boo. Let's get down and dirty, and I will see you guys in a bit. Alrighty then, my little crafty monsters, let's get down and dirty and make these little bad boys. So these are some really easy but fancy looking little Mother's Day cards that we will be making. And we will be using that die set from David to Tara, I think, if I'm even saying his name right. I have a collection of his flower stuff. You know, he does a lot of weddings. So I'm getting this little sentiment from this Mother's Day stamp set that I had purchased at Michael's a few years back. This is the only Mother's Day set that I have. I don't usually make Mother's Day cards because, well, my mom's an angel, and it's really only my sister and my niece that I usually give something to. But anywho, we're going to go ahead and start off by stamping the sentiment onto this little card stock, onto the card base. Now, if you guys don't know about card bases and card mats, there will be a link to a tutorial that will explain to you on the 101 on card making. So once you are done stamping your little, don't forget to go ahead and wipe down your little mats and make sure you put them away pretty clean so that they're ready for the next project. And so, like I said, this is the only Mother's Day stamp set that I have, so we are going to just work with what we have. Now I am going to go ahead and cut down the card mats. These are the card mats that are going to go in front of the card bases, and we're going to just go ahead and cut those down a quarter of an inch smaller than our card base, and this will give us a little frame all around where that little cream color card base will go ahead and peep out. So I'm just going to use my static pouch to go ahead and rub it onto these card mats so that the embossing powder will not stick in areas that I do not want it to stick on. So we're going to go ahead and get our watermark ink, and we're going to go ahead and get our powder ready. Get everything ready so that once you stamp this little sentiment, you are just ready to go ahead and grab your card mat and throw that powder on there so that you're not really wasting any time and you're not allowing that watermark to dry up. So right here, I'm just going to make sure that I rub that little static tool, stamp this little bad boy on there, and then we're going to go ahead and throw the powder on that. And that's how easy it is. Then all you have to do really is just heat it. And then when you're heating something that's embossed, just know that whenever you add heat to paper, it's going to warp a little bit. But if you're very careful on how you're heating your embossed area, there will be times when your paper will not even warp at all. So just be careful when you're heating it. Don't put the heat too directly onto the paper. Have it kind of a little distance, but enough to where it's going to heat up that powder. And so once you heat up the powder, it turns into that metallic silver, which is basically what we were going for. I really, really love how embossed sentiments look. And so now all we're going to do is we're going to get our distress inks, and I'm going to go ahead and just put like little circles here and there. There is no right or wrong way to do this, guys, honestly. So now I'm just trying to soften out those edges so it just doesn't look like a complete circle. And then I'm going to go in with basically four different colors to go ahead and mimic as if these were little flowers that are going to be peeping through the translucent leaves. You guys are going to see how it's going to look. It just looks so pretty. I really fell in love with this card. So go ahead and just continue to add whatever colors you guys want. Like I said, there is no right or wrong way. You guys could just go ahead and add whatever colors you want and whatever colors you don't want. Excuse me, I actually thought that I turned off that ringer, but apparently I didn't. So now we're just gonna go ahead and add a little bit of this broken china just to give it some other color in it. And then we're going to go ahead and take out this sheet of vellum paper. Now this vellum paper, I do purchase it at the Hobby Lobbies. So go ahead and run to your Hobby Lobbies. Well, don't run. I mean, walk pretty fast, but you know, it isn't classy to run, ladies. It's always to walk a little fast, as in saying, I'm worth the wait. So anyway, go ahead and fold your little vellum and then just throw on whatever leaf dyes you guys have. If you guys don't have any leaf dyes, you guys could go ahead and use some paper punches, anything that you guys have. If it's just a single leaf of a paper punch, then you're basically going to have to do some layering. But if you do have like a whole branch like this, then by all means, it's going to work a lot easier for you. I mean, it's easy both ways, honestly, to tell you the truth. Don't get discouraged, my little crafty monsters. It's super, super easy. And so what I noticed was I used three whole branches per card. And then I had to use a single leaf to do all the covering, to cover up all of the glue parts. You guys will see. Because when you're trying to glue vellum onto paper, you're going to notice that, well, the vellum is translucent. So any kind of adhesive you add to this, it will show. So what we're going to do is we're going to get our little rubber mat and then our ATG gun. Right here, I'm not using the rubber mat, but I do use it afterwards. And I'm just adding a little bit of glue onto the actual branch, nowhere else. And then I'm going to go ahead and tuck some of these branches underneath the other leaves. And this is just so that you will not be able to see that glue area. And then once you have that corner, then what you're going to do is just cut off all of the little excess leaves that are sticking out from your card. And then just get one single leaf, and we're going to go ahead and cover those little branches. You guys will see right now. And obviously, I'm not doing what I'm saying I'm doing, but there you go. So just get that one leaf, and then you're covering all of those little glue areas, and then go ahead and cut that little bad boy. So that one leaf on the corner is working as a cover-up for, you know, so you don't see all that adhesive. So here's that rubber mat because Jesse got a little bit smarter. And we're going to go ahead and put down the first one. And then, like I said, we're going to, every branch that we lay down, we're going to lay it underneath of the previous leaf so that you can't really see that glue. So if you notice, I pick up the leaf and then I throw it underneath. And that just really helps to kind of mask whatever glue you guys have added onto your little vellum. Make sure that you're only adding it to the tips of your branches anyway, because, I mean, this is a card, so you don't have to worry about it getting messed up or ripped or anything like that. Most likely, nobody ever really mistreats a greeting card, so don't worry about that, guys. You want it to be dainty and very feminine and very beautiful looking. This is for that special somebody who gave somebody else life or gave you life, so let's put our all into these cards, right? And so now that we have all of the little flowers and the leaves and the sentiments, I'm going to go ahead and just add a few little blings here and there. I'm going to add four per card. And I limit myself to four per card because I don't want to overdrown this card. Remember, less is more. And so even with just those four right there, it just made everything pop.
Welcome back, my little crafty monsters. That's how easy it was to make these little bad boys. I mean, do not tell me, boo-boo. Do not tell me this was not easy to make, because y'all know it was. You know it was. This was a really simple, easy way to do a beautiful card for your mama or for one of your friends who's a mama. And give this out to them, because, I mean, like, this is amazing and super easy. You don't really need a lot of tools. I mean, if you don't have these leaves right here, maybe you have a paper punch, layer them. Maybe you have a different kind of a die. Well, then use whatever you got, boo-boo. Use what you got. But this is kind of an idea. I've seen a bunch of cards like this, and I just thought, hey, you know, why not, you know, where they do the inking in the back and then the vellum stuff on the top. Well, why not, you know, why not do it like this? So I'm going to have maybe about two more cards coming up, and then we're going to be done. We're going to do three cards for Mother's Day. I know I was trying to get some Cinco de Mayo stuff in, but damn, that Cinco de Mayo came up here like a... Ooh, like a freight train, boo-boo. By the time I was getting ready, it was like, what? What? Today's Cinco de Mayo? I was like, no. Okay, you know what? Then it's done. We're over with. So, you know, that was on Sunday. So, anywho, boo-boo. We only have a few more days for Mother's Day, so let's get at least three cards in there. I was going to do some projects, but honestly, to tell you the truth, I feel like as an adult, let's just buy our parents something. But as a kid, well, there's a lot of kiddie project Mother's Day stuff out there, so they're really easy. There's a lot of little cute ones, and I don't know if you guys are even down to see little kitty craft like that, but I mean, everybody needs to make a card for their parents, so why not make one of these? And that's how easy it was. So anyway, I hope that inspires you guys to make a little card for your loved one. And that's it for now, my little crafty monsters. I hope you enjoyed that video as much as I enjoyed making it for you guys. Don't forget to subscribe. Go ahead and subscribe, boo-boo. There's that little picture of me floating around there. Grab that little sucker and become a BFF with me. I mean, because who doesn't want to be my BFF, right? And then share and tell a friend, because your friends also need to know how fabulous these tutorials are. And until next time, my little crafty monsters, goodbye.